Welcome to the longest running, the original, the only trilingual Filipino-Chinese lifestyle magazine show, Chinatown TV. I'm your host, Candice Tan. 您现在收看的是非中电视台. Happy New Year, everyone! 祝大家兔年快乐,大吉大利,万事如意! 愿你的新年像兔子一样祥和美好! Sa kahit anumang celebration, na mapa-Filipino man or Chinese, hindi pwedeng mawala ang masasarap na pagkain. 中国家庭在大年初一的前夜,也就是大年三十晚上, 都会和家人一起吃团圆饭。 相信一家人一起吃顿饭，来年就会兴旺发达。每家每户的年夜饭都有各式各样丰富的特色菜肴。The traditional food associated with Lunar New Year or Chinese New Year is diverse in form and flavor, and many dishes are associated with symbols, myths, and superstitions that give them special significance. There's something for everyone in the Lunar New Year spread. Sweet and savory, crunchy and soft, meat and vegetarian. Bring on prosperity in the year of the rabbit with Lunar New Year dishes that range from savory to sweet, crunchy to creamy here at the Commissary of Yao's Kitchen. And later on, they will be sharing with us delectable authentic Chinese dishes. At hindi lang yan, we will also show you how their bestseller dishes are cooked to perfection. My New Year's resolution is to be able to cook delicious, authentic Chinese dishes, so I'm so glad for this opportunity to learn some of Yao Kitchen's secrets. 希望我这一次可以学会做几道美味中国菜. Pero bago yan, let's watch our first segment for today.
China's rich cultural heritage spans over 5,000 years at sinasabing isa ito sa pinakamatanda at complex cultures in the world. With its unique customs, traditions, and practices, China has a lot to offer to those who are interested in exploring its fascinating culture. As we delve into the vast and diverse culture of China, ating kikilalanin ang kanilang mayamang kultura na nagpasalin-salin na sa mga henerasyon. From traditional Chinese medicine to the art of calligraphy, there is much to explore and learn about. Join us on our journey to uncover these fascinating aspects of Chinese culture and more as we delve deeper into the wonders of this ancient and diverse civilization. At ang aming unang handog na video sa inyo ay isang paglalakbay patungo sa puso ng sining Chino sa ating pagtuklas sa splendors of Mount Hua, isang obra maestra na likha ng kilalang pintor na si Fu Baoshi. Sa video na ito, saksihan natin ang mahiwagang paglipat ng simpleng tinta sa papel patungo sa isang buhay na tanawin ng bundok Hua na itinuturing bilang isa sa pinakamakahulugan at mapanganib na bundok sa China. Tuklasin natin ang kanyang kakaibang teknik na Tsunfa, ang sining ng paglikha ng kulubot at tekstura na nagbibigay buhay sa mga bato, puno at iba't ibang elemento ng kalikasan.
Stroke upon stroke, the brush, infused with ink, adds to the majestic presence of Mount Hua, reputed to be the most thrilling and dangerous mountain in China. Voices break the silence of an empty mountain, prompting curious travelers to seek the source of the sound. Boisterous children play in front of a few cottages scattered inside the valley. We could almost hear the clinking of wine glasses and smell the aroma of wine that also intoxicates the pine trees. The loftiness of Mount Hua is captured by this image of incredible scope and details. Splendors of Mount Hua is a pioneering work of modern Chinese landscape painting. Created by renowned Chinese artist Fu Baoshi, it is a testament to the artist's mastery of Cunfa, a unique wrinkling technique which exhibits intricate nuances in a landscape, with brushstrokes creating the flow, texture, perspective, volume, and interplay of light and shadow. Dotting strokes suggest glistening water droplets on rocks. Axe-cut strokes show the rugged and angular texture of rocks. Here we witness the masterful Cunfa technique of Fu Baoshi, which has become closely associated with the artist's name. Concentrated strokes are dispersed with countless wrinkles, trailing ink behind. The brush runs free, with no trace of beginning nor end. Yet volume is formed with light and darkness. The canvas pulsates with life, grand and sublime. This iconic Cunfa technique was created by Fu Baoshi during the War of Resistance against Japanese aggression, when he taught art at the National Central University and the National College of Art in the wartime capital Chongqing. There, he hiked daily through rugged mountains and bamboo forests. While awed by the majestic beauty of the landscape, Fu Baoshi was also depressed to see the shattered state of his homeland. The artist was torn between two worlds. On a stormy night, fueled by a few sips of Chinese spirit, his anger towards the invasion of his country and pride in his nation's dignity gushed forth. He picked up a brush and broke from the traditional, gentle style of Chinese painting. He scattered the strokes, heightened the stress, and sped up the pace. That was when the iconic Baoshi Cun, the Cunfa technique named after him, was born. Amidst the turmoil of wartime China in 1942, Fu Baoshi's art exhibit caused a sensation.
These paintings represent a new life. This new life is Chinese people's life force. Against foreigners, against anyone who is not friendly to us, in front of life,
Over a decade later, Fu Baoshi, then director of the Traditional Fine Art Institute of Southeast China's Jiangsu Province, led a team of about a dozen artists on a three-month-long journey, covering a distance of over 7,000 miles to paint the rich and varied landscapes across China. In the presence of the towering peaks of Mount Hua, one of the iconic mountains known for being a cradle for Chinese culture, the fire of artistic creation was lit again in Fu Baoshi's heart. This time, not by dreary sights of a nation in distress, but an overwhelming sense of pride and aspiration for all the magnificent landscape of his motherland. Fu Baoshi took up the brush again and let his legendary Baoshi Cun technique play its magic. one can almost hear his vigorous brushstrokes break on the paper as he paints. A perfect union of the bold and the subtle. Fu Baoshe's painting brought out not only the spirit of a mountain, but also that of a nation. Chinese ink and brush paintings can be more than ideals and romanticism, ethereal scenery, and personal aspirations. They can also embody a nation's sentiment in times of triumph and tragedy.
Chinatown TV. I'm your host Candice Dan. 您现在收看的是非洲电视台, and we are still here at 𝗟𝗎𝗄𝗎's Kitchen. Now I'm sure a lot of you have tried the delectable dishes from 𝗟𝗎𝗄𝗎's Kitchen, but have you ever wondered who is the person behind all those mouth-watering recipes? Well, here with me right now is Miss Jennifer Yao, the head chef of all the food that we see here at 𝗟𝗎𝗄𝗎's Kitchen. Hello, Miss Yao.
Hello.
非常感谢您接受我们非洲电视台的采访。那我的第一个问题是，您当时为什么想要开一个Yao's Kitchen呢？
我爱煮食人，我是爱煮食人，所以喺度到爱煮食。了，我再惊，再我讲啦，我从一个小小菜馆，哦，因为做开馆了，啊，2016开始，了则 after 2 years 则pandemic。
没，这pandemic只是安尼才开始，所以才关了，只是我哎，不是，现在就是已经没有才，
没有，现在就是全部是网上的，是，OK，然后你刚才有跟我说，你看你们这里真的是很漂亮，很丰富，然后您刚才说的这个就是那个五个，
这个lucky five，这个lucky five是常常人家讲，家讲叫，讲这个白围帽这上人真好看，嗯。 So Yao's Kitchen is mainly in the online business. So if you're interested, you can order from them. 那我们现在呢，已经是 Chinese New
Year了，你们有没有什么特色菜？就是昨天，特别过去那是创造米线，特别做米线，过后在虾、过鱼，哦，就是在，就是我有点 online 的看到，我们还物件。你啊，你啊爱讲你爱什么款的，我们可能够家己创。
OK，所以如果我们想要点一个什么菜，但是没有在 menu，你们可以帮我们做。OK，so I guess that is what separates Yao's Kitchen from the rest because you can customize your dish。哇哦，然后这里有 birthday 米刷，然后呢，我们也有我们的点心，那个鱿鱼。然后呢，我真的觉得很酷，因为这些都是你自己的 recipe，对吧？那您当时。 要开一家 Yao's Kitchen 的时候，你有没有想过应该要煮什么呀？要需不需要健康啊？能不能跟我们说一下？是的，怎么准备的？我有讲买给人吃，我无要开什么用
MSG。
好，OK，我说我用 MSG。哦，perfect。哦，大家个个健，没很多油，没很多用的盐。 Yes,
okay. 不然咱出来的煮的，不是用那点菜馆常常吃的。Okay,
so wow, what I love about Yao's Kitchen, Yunga, like if you order it, you know that you are eating healthy food, so it's not greasy, they don't add MSG, that's actually very important, and less on salt. 我觉得这个很重要，因为现在大家不只是喜欢吃好吃的东西，但是呢，也要健康。所以如果我们在 Yao's Kitchen 买他们的 菜的话，那就是就好像自己家人的家庭。So it's really made with love and care. Well, I really love it. So how about Miss Jennifer? What is your personal favorite dish? 你自己最喜欢的？那个，这个，这个，为什么喜欢这个？嗯，我爱吃
seafood 的，我爱吃 crab，
吃 crab。那这个是有点酸还是甜的？
又是。 那是咸的物件，咸的，咸的。嗯，是个。那您当时，那您现在在厨房里面有一家很大的厨房，它里面在运营，一起在煮饭。那有很多帮手吗？都是自己家人吗？我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我，我 home cooked food.
Okay. So you not only do you have dishes that you can order, but I heard that you also have meal plans that you serve weekly. Can you tell us about that? Here in Yao's kitchen, they plan your meal ahead and they deliver it to your house, whether if it's for 2 to 3 days lang or if you want 1 week. Wow, that's incredible. And I heard that aside from just the dishes, you also give frozen goods,
right? Yes,
yes.
Okay. Oh,
okay.
That's
amazing. 那如果我想要 order, 比如我想要在 Yao's kitchen order, 应该要怎么 order? 是要怎么打电话吗？提前？
可不可以那种，我今天打电话，然后呢，今天就可以拿到。有的物件，有的物件，有的物件，有时我就买，就买啊。所以个清楚的物件，你要提两日给我讲，或一日给我讲。比如做米线，做点心就无问题。Okay,
so mommy saw show my dim sum, you can order it on the spot, they will deliver it to you. But for some other specialty dishes, it's better that you can order a day or two beforehand. Okay, amazing, great. You know, I'm actually very excited to try out the dishes. 真的很期待，因为我在这里只能闻得到他们有多香。然后呢，我想现在Chinese Okay, so I'm really excited to try this one. I'm loving it so much. Wow, so they really did it themselves from scratch. And you can also order it frozen.
Yes.
Okay, let's put some sauce. So this is their lucky five, no?
Yes.
So yun, to those who want to order for their birthdays, Chinese New Year, you can order this one, lucky five. Wow. I love it. And then now let's try out their, look at that. Wow. Okay, let's try it. Wow. I love it. Like when I bit into it, juice just burst inside my mouth. So I'm just loving all the dishes. As you can see, these are all perfect for Chinese New Year, birthday celebrations, all kinds of celebrations because these are all auspicious dishes. Auspicious dishes, why? That hill, you can see it's very colorful, vibrant, very red. And as well as we have the yu, which is prosperity, as well as the fa cai, so yun wealth, it's like a money dish, as well as the birthday noodles, the noodles for long life, and then shrimp, cilantro, mushroom, nuts. Nuts, what's the story behind the nuts?
Nuts is just part of the traditional miso. It's a Fukien, the other is Cantonese.
And I'm really loving, how Yao's Kitchen also have the lucky five. So they're like all dishes, you are happy because, no, you are happy because when you eat it, it's not only healthy, delicious, but you know that you are eating in prosperity, wealth, and auspiciousness. So thank you so much, Ms. Yao, for sharing with us all.
Thank you.
Hi, it's Alex from Yao's Kitchen. So if you want to order homemade comfort Chinese food for catering, packed meals, food tray, tiap chai, or frozen goods, visit their website at Yao's Kitchen PH or follow them on socials on Facebook and Instagram. Kong hai pa choy! Welcome back to Chinatown TV, and this is it. Miss Yao is going to teach me how to cook beef salpicao. So, what's the first step?
Just over, put the butter on first. Okay, butter ko. Pero malaki sa ito.
Yun, wow. Butter. Sige, stay here. Butter. So, first step, butter. Mmm, sizzling mushrooms. Sarap. Wow.
Hindi, okay, sautéed. Sige. Okay. Sige,
so. So, kanina, she said na parang cook lang ng mushroom. It's actually edible na, you can eat it. But just so that the flavor will pop out even more.
Okay, oyster sauce.
Ah, okay, oyster sauce.
Okay,
ito.
Put some seasoning.
Seasoning. Pepper.
Black pepper.
Wow.
Ang konting tubig.
Tubig?
Hmm. Yung cooking, yung beef ko, ito yatwahi.
Hmm, okay.
Kasi pwedeng half-cook ang...
Ah, kailangan.
Gusto mo ng medium. Malagka ng well done. It's almost done. Almost done.
Try it.
Yeah,
yeah,
you try it.
Wow.
Okay, let's eat it. Okay.
Woohoo! Wow, it's hot. It's a red bar.
No. You bought it at wrong. It's a wrong.
What about that? Yeah, you know. So I'm doing it. My New Year's resolution. Cook. Good food. So wow, my very first dish with the guidance of Yao's Kitchen's Miss Jennifer Yao, head chef.
Then there's garlic.
Garlic.
Minced garlic.
Fried garlic. Anything else?
Katampo seasoning.
Sige sige. Katampo. Yes. So good. Ah, I love it. Sige, let's try it.
Let's try it.
Let's try it together.
Yes.
Mmm. Mmm.
Very good.
Very flavorful. Very tender. Just like all the other dishes.
Mmm.
And now, as I finish it off, here's more of Chinatown TV. We still have a lot of interesting programs waiting for you to watch.
Sa kanyang mga paglalakbay sa iba't ibang sulok ng China sa paglipas ng mga taon, ang dating punong ministro ng Belgium na si Yves Leterme ay labis na humanga sa mabilis at malawakang pag-unlad ng infrastruktura sa bansang ito. Sa isang panayam kasama ang China Media Group o CMG, buong paghanga niyang inilahad ang kahanga-hangang pag-asenso ng China sa sektor ng infrastruktura sa nakalipas na mga dekada. Samahan niyo kami sa pagsisiyasat ng mga hakbang at inobasyon na nagbigay daan sa China na magkaroon ng ganitong kalaking transformasyon at kung paano ito naging inspirasyon at aral para sa ibang mga bansa sa daigdig.
You've been here in China over 20 times in the past two decades, also including during the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games. So what changes taking place in this country that really impress you the most over the period?
Well, I've had the privilege to visit lots of places in China. And what I saw at the start was a overwhelmingly impressive deployment of infrastructure development, investment in roads and railroads and high-quality infrastructure. You still see this in Greater Bay Area, Shanghai, Beijing, but it's actually spreading all over China. And so I think for a Westerner, the volume of infrastructural development, but also the speed, mm-hmm. is really, for me, the most impressive. And together with the fact that the situation of the people, the citizens, the average citizens, is really improved over the last 15-20 years, of course. Yeah.
Ngayon naman ay samahan natin si Sisi sa kanyang kauna-unahang vlog for 2024. Dadalhin niya tayo sa isa sa pinakamagandang yaman ng lungsod ng Beijing, ang Summer Palace. Dito, hindi lamang ang kagandahan ng palasyo ang ating masisilayan, kundi pati na rin ang kasiyahan ng isang paborito aktibidad tuwing taglamig, ang ice skating.
Kumusta po mga kaibigan Pinoy? Ito po Sisi. Welcome sa kauna-unahang vlog ko para sa happy year of 2024. Unang weekend na bagong taon at on the way ako ngayon sa Summer Palace sa Gawihilagang ng Beijing para subukan ang isang season-limited na amusement activity. Yun, ice skating. Wow, ang dami daw! Ang temperatura ngayon ay -5 degrees Celsius. Pero kahit maginaw ang panahon sa Beijing, kapag nariyan ang sunshine, sikat na araw, parang lumalabas ang lahat ng tao. Hindi dapat magsuot ako ng yung rubber shoes. Sobrang slippery. Oh, sled dog ba mga ito? Sled dog! Tingnan niyo. Ah! Hindi todo. Kumari lang ang mga ito. Napaka-funny ng kilos nila. Just like you and me. Ayaw na ayaw magtrabaho pagkatapos ng Christmas and New Year holiday, di ba? Okay, ang mga ito ay sasakyan na pwede kong pinili for today. Ito ang yon pinaka traditional na type. Isang chair, kasama ng dalawang ice wand. At ito naman ang bicycle type. Kung wala pa kayong karanasan ng ice skating, mas maganda kung bibiliin ninyo ang bicycle type dahil ito ay mas madaling imaneho. Pero siguro less fun ah. Ang rent ng lahat ng mga ito ay 50 yuan renminbi o mga 400 pesos isang araw. Let's go! Napagalagi ng ice skating rink sa Summer Palace at ito ay may 35
1,000 square meters na kadumbas ng 8 football courts. Pinubuksan ito sa publiko tuwing Enero at nananatiling bukas hanggang sa unang dako ng Pebrero. Mga 30 to 35 araw lamang na pwedeng maglaro dito. Kaya naman ito ay isang season limited na kasayahan ng mga taga Beijing.
Nag-imas maginaw sa pandakit na nalawa. Kung walang nag-swot ng gloves, 2-3 minutes lang naging frozen stiff ang mga kamay. Kalikot ko ay yung language here. Maganda ito kahit anumang panahon at kailan tingnan mo.
Yeah, ang pinaka-interesting na pa rin na pag-skate sa Summer Palace Skating Rink ang Super Tray. Kung gusto niyo sumali, kailangan ilagay ang waba sa yuba ng ice wagon ng karalo sa harap niyo. Parang kayo. At dahil tuloy-tuloy na gumagalaw ang minya, kailangan mabilis ang paggalaw.
Oh, naglaro lang ako ng 2 oras pero super gudong. Walang bilo, I can eat a horse. Okay, diyan nagdadapos our game vlog para sa today. Don't worry, Sisi. Bye-bye. See you next week.
The Vismin Merchants Amity Association Incorporated held a celebration of its 46th founding anniversary and New Year party. Philippine Nantao Mao Yishang Lian Yi Hui, Ju Xing Qing Chu Cheng Li, Si Shi Liu Zhou Nian, Ji Hui Yuan Xin Chun Lian Huan Da Hui.
2024年1月4号晚，菲律宾南岛贸易商联谊会假作世纪海鲜酒家举行庆祝成立46周年暨2024年会员新春联欢大会。飞华友好社团代表、嘉宾等应邀出席盛会。理事长蔡成辉担任大会主席，他在致辞中表示，过去三年里，面对疫情和自然灾害，各行各业严重衰退。 菲律宾南岛贸易商联谊会全体同仁面对逆境和困难，同心协力，守望相助。展望未来，南岛贸易商联谊会同仁将继续积极投入工作，努力发挥桥梁作用，促进非中经贸发展，增进非中人民友谊。他同时感谢全体同仁对他的支持和信任。在新的一年，他将尽心尽力发展会务。 不负重托，愿同仁们在新的一年精诚团结，努力把各项工作做得更好。该会永远荣誉会长吴申谋大律师和飞华商联总会理事长施东方博士等先后训会。 执行副理事长陈瑞仁致谢词，黄景苍、许新伟担任大会司仪。联欢大会进行了聚餐、祝酒、抽奖以及娱乐节目表演。
The Chiang Kai-shek College High School Batch 2003 held its 20th alumni homecoming celebration. 菲律宾中正学院中学 2003年度集友会 举行回校20周年庆祝会。
2023年11月18号晚， 菲律宾中正学院中学2003年度集友会甲中正纪念堂举行回校20周年庆祝会。 母校校长叶启明博士暨行政人员、校友总会会长李景思及执行委员们、老师们，以及2003年度集友协卷出席参加，大家欢聚一堂，气氛热烈。母校校长叶启明博士和校友总会会长李景思先后致辞，勉励集友们要团结互助。 希望他们会一如既往地支持母校和校友会的各项活动。To
our alumni from high school class 2003, we welcome you back to our alma mater. Do continue to support our alma mater because this is our second home and this will always be your second home.
This reunion is an opportunity to reconnect, to rekindle old friendship. I hope that batch 2003 will continue this legacy of supporting not only the Alumni Association, but more so, our beloved alma mater.
Everyone
tonight will agree with me that Chiang Kai-shek has been a big part of our lives. We are now where we are today because of the experiences we had during our stay here, the friends we gained, and of course the lessons we learned from our teachers.
期间还有丰富多彩的余庆节目表演和抽奖等活动，庆祝会在欢乐的气氛中圆满结束。非中新闻台综合报道。
有利东方旅游有限公司，Union Travel Incorporated。
The Filipino-Chinese Youth Business Association Incorporated held a celebration of its 8th founding anniversary and 4th officers induction ceremony. 非华青商会举行庆祝成立8周年暨第四届职员就职典礼。
2024年1月6号晚， 非华青商会加座马尼拉大酒店大宴会厅隆重举行庆祝成立8周年暨第四届职员就职典礼，非华友好社团代表嘉宾等应邀出席典礼仪式。
会长王明渠担任大会主席并致辞，他感谢同仁们在其任期内所给予的支持与合作，使会务工作得以顺利进行。相信在新届会长曾飞虎的带领下，定能续写更加灿烂的明天。希望全体同仁团结一致，凝心聚力，为居住国与祖籍国的各项事业贡献该有的力量。少年自由，少年华。
非华商联总会理事长施东方博士担任金誓员，见证印信移交并训会。商总理事长施东方博士颁发就任荣誉盾牌与新任会长曾飞虎，曾飞虎会长颁发就任荣誉盾牌与执行副会长和常务副会长，创会会长蔡荣轩颁发就任荣誉盾牌与副会长。 而名誉会长王明渠颁发就任荣誉盾牌与正副监事长。新界会长曾飞虎在致辞中感谢各位同仁对他的信任， 给予他继续学习成长的机会。他表示一定会竭尽所能推动会务迈上新的台阶，让非华青商会成为非华社会年轻创业者交流学习互助共赢的优质平台。希望全体成员未来更加团结，共同努力，为非华青商会的发展贡献自己的力量，并创写更加辉煌的篇章。该会指导员、非华各界联合会名誉主席杨华红担任大会主讲人，中国驻菲律宾使馆王月参赞兼总领事出席并致辞，非华各界联合会主席蔡永明、菲律宾中国商会副会长洪俊、菲律宾晋江同乡总会理事长姚金镇、世界泉州青年联谊会马来西亚分会会长刘博文先后致辞。期间，班赠感谢状语名誉会长王明曲、监事员施东方博士、主讲人杨华红、指导员永远荣誉会长及荣誉会长，然后捐献福利金与多个团体。会长陈伟群致谢词，秘书长蔡金景介绍主讲人，非中电视台主持人施佩文介绍主宾席宾主，并与非中电视台副台长庄玲玲共同担任大会司仪。典礼仪式之后，进行了聚餐、祝酒、抽奖以及娱乐节目表演等活动。
一起人一条路，
The Filipino-Chinese Friendship Association Incorporated held a celebration of its 49th founding anniversary and 25th officers induction ceremony. 非中友好协会举行庆祝成立49周年暨第25届职员就职典礼。
2024年1月7日中午，非中友好协会假作世纪海鲜酒家隆重举行庆祝成立49周年暨第25届职员就职典礼，非华友好社团代表嘉宾等应邀出席典礼仪式。第24届理事长王孝等担任大会主席并致辞，他衷心感谢同仁们在其任期内所给予的支持与关爱，他高度肯定新界理事长施碧波的才能，相信在他的带领下，非中友好协会的会务一定会更上一层楼，希望同仁们同心协力，为促进非中友好交流做出更多贡献。名誉理事长蔡沧江博士担任监事员，见证异性移交并训诲。新界理事长施碧波在致辞中重申，非中友好协会的主要目标是促进菲律宾和中国人民之间的了解和友谊，希望同仁们与非中友好组织和人士合作，成为文化交流、经济合作和人际交往的引领者，为非中两国民间交流的持久合作共赢创造更加光明的未来。非华商联总会理事长施东方博士担任大会主讲人，中国驻菲律宾使馆施伟健领事出席并致辞，非华各界联合会主席蔡永明、菲律宾华裔青年联合会创会会长洪义华、全球和平基金会会长塞尔达纳·尼卡福特博士、亚典药大学孔子学院中方院长梁广涵等先后致辞。期间颁赠感谢盾牌于大会主席王孝等、监事员蔡沧江博士、主讲人施东方博士。随后，新界理事长施碧波个人捐献商总华商流失补助金、菲律宾钱江联合会福利金、菲律宾金南郎军社福利金。 执行副理事长吴玉章致谢词，副理事长王勇介绍主讲人，秘书长非中电视台副制作人兼新闻总监王学义介绍主宾席宾主，并与非中电视台主持人施冰仪共同担任大会司仪。典礼仪式之后，进行了聚餐、祝酒、抽奖以及娱乐节目表演等活动。 新闻台综合报道。
The 2023 China Film Festival movies will be screened in multiple provinces and cities in the Philippines during the Lunar New Year. 2023中国电影节电影将于农历新年期间在菲律宾多个省市轮番展映。
2023年11月28号， 由中国驻菲律宾使馆、中国电影资料馆主办， 菲律宾影视审查分级委员会、电影发展委员会、每家商场支持的2023中国电影节在马尼拉举办开幕式，非政府各部门高级官员及各领域嘉宾、各国驻菲使团、华人华侨、中资机构和留学生代表近300人出席活动。中国驻菲律宾大使黄希濂、非电影发展委员会主席克鲁兹、 影视审查分级委员会委员莉莉安、每家商场助理副总裁兼集群总经理盛安娜、非总统中国事务特使许志军、国家文化艺术委员会主席马纳罗等主持了开幕式。2023中国电影节展映周期为2023年11月28号至2024年2月22号，活动期间热烈《长安三万里》、 《流浪地球2》、《封神第一部》、《朝歌风云》、《中国乒乓之绝地反击》、《熊出没》、《伴我雄心》等六部中国电影将在菲律宾多个省市轮番展映，让更多非基层民众有机会在大屏幕前欣赏到题材多样、内涵丰富的数字高清格式中国大片，感受当代中国发展成就和中国文化现代化表达。
The Chiang Kai-shek College held its 2023 Christmas party. 菲律宾中正学院举行2023年圣诞联欢会。
2023年12月2号上午10点30分， 菲律宾中正学院在中正纪念堂举行2023年圣诞联欢会。首先由董事会董事长陈义维致欢迎词，他向全体师生致以节日的问候。
I would like to take these occasions to express our gratitude and appreciation to all our esteemed teachers and school personnel for the invaluable work that you do each day. Every effort, no matter how small, goes a long way to help nurture and teach the children. Build a safe and inclusive environment for them to grow and inspire them to work harder and aim for their dreams. To show our appreciation for your unwavering commitment to the work that you do, we hope that you will enjoy the Christmas bonus prepared by the Board of Trustees as heartfelt thanks.
董事会全体董事向劳苦功高的教师们颁赠年终礼金。随后， 阿尔波拉多老师做自主项目收支报告，再由校长叶启明博士分发自主项目利润，最后还举行了抽彩，许丽丽主任担任司仪。午餐期间，学校师生们准备了丰富多彩的余兴节目表演。
非中新闻台综合报道。
商总向劳工部全国反对童工委员会移交100包礼品包，以赠送给童工及家人。
FFCCCII donated gift packs to the Department of Labor and Employment National Council against Child Labor.
近日，非华社联总会向劳工部全国反对童工委员会移交100包装有学校用品和卫生用品的礼品包。该批物资将由该委员会代为赠送给童工和他们的家庭成员。当天，劳工部全国反对童工委员会劳工部国都区办事处高级劳工及就业长官德洛斯·雷耶斯一行前往商总接收该批赠送物资。移交仪式由理事长施东方博士、董事兼劳工主任施嘉年、劳工副主任戴从容、劳工理事严峰、秘书长助理陈光灿等领导主持。期间，施东方理事长等诸领导与德洛斯·雷耶斯一行在商总法律策略中心办事处进行座谈交流。德洛斯·雷耶斯代表劳工部和社会民众向商总的慷慨赠送表达万分谢意。非中新闻台综合报道。
The Philippine Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated GAVIDE Chapter had a year-end charity event. 菲律宾中国商会贾美丽省分会举行2023年岁末爱心活动。
2023年12月20号上午10点，菲律宾中国商会贾美丽省分会领导及同仁们分批次前往各市政府拜访市长等政府官员，并为各市政府官员送去丰富的圣诞礼物和新年祝福，以表达该分会重视国民外交与关心弱势群体的精神，受到各市政府领导的热烈欢迎及诚挚感谢。是日，执行副会长陈清源带领同仁拜访了诺维雷塔市政府，执行副会长陈万官带领同仁拜访了罗萨里奥市政府，陈英姿副会长带领同仁拜访了卡韦特市政府，张玉士副会长带领同仁拜访了巴库尔市政府，徐海罗副会长带领同仁拜访了伊木斯市政府，吴金忠副会长带领同仁拜访了贾美丽市政府，陈小新副会长带领同仁拜访了坦扎市政府。同日下午两点，丁燕副会长带领同仁前往斯朗市残疾孤儿院，为该院管理员及孤儿共100多人送去岁末圣诞礼物及现金25万菲币。出席此次活动的该会领导及同仁有王明仁、陈清源、陈万官、丁燕、吴金忠、徐海罗、陈小星、陈英姿、张玉士、詹坤义、王伯克、洪伟丽、汪海文、王思春、吴志安、王诗达、王安南、苏孙彪、刘丽玲、蔡天涯、蔡家晓、李家应、李其仁、李家辉、张春平、陈家文、王明勇、郑安平、杨延坤、李安娜、张莹宇等。 Chinatown News 非中新闻台综合报道。
The Manila Chinatown Charity Foundation distributed Christmas presents to vulnerable people.
马尼拉华人区义诊中心发放圣诞物资于弱势群众。
2023年12月10号上午，马尼拉华人区义诊中心再次对弱势群体展开爱心济贫活动，一共发放了500份，每份5公斤大米，广泛惠及该区苗龙崖前来问诊之病患。该中心义工还有仙尼圭拉市南区志愿防火队义工及员警。是日，该中心诸领导均参加帮忙，由行政主任严德庆、副主任徐焕然、蔡安顺、严启明，名誉会长吴子文教授、陈建峰、蔡孝健、严永洲、林光威、施天来、吴婷婷牙医博士，秘书长庄伟东、姚明义，财政严户桥、基和李正中，总务吴洋洋，外交施清波、施纯贤、邱朱丽， 陈礼道、吴清泉、施鹏辉、王自强、徐宝珠、中医部、药物部、牙医部等共同主持帮忙分发。中国驻菲律宾大使馆关怀基层大众，再度捐助该中心医药补助金人民币20,000元。当天，王岳参赞兼总领事和施伟健领事等亲临该中心视察义诊现场，并移交善款，受到该中心朱领导的热情接待。王岳参赞兼总领事表示，希望大家能够共同为慈善事业努力，好让基层民众认识到中国人的爱心与他们同在。非中新闻台综合报道。
The Chuchi Foundation signed a memorandum of agreement with the Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Manila. 慈济与马尼拉市政府大学签署备忘录。
马尼拉市政府大学校长多米戈·雷耶斯律师于2023年12月22号在马尼拉慈济置业园区与慈济菲律宾分会执行长杨国英正式签署协定备忘录。慈济与 PLM 的合作始于2005年，他们的助学方案涵盖学生的学费和日常生活补贴金，每季度还提供大米和各种日用品，同时每个月还有人文课程给学生了解做人做事各方面的道德理念，希望让学生们有机会成为受人尊敬、负责任和富有爱心的人品典范。慈济希望与 PLM 不仅在学术领域继续维持和加强合作关系，而且希望在促进学生提高社会责任感的专案中，让他们更多地了解他们将来对国家及社会的责任。慈济基金会与 PLM 多年的合作，培养了无数年轻有为的校友，其中一位是贾米尔·卡瓦哈尔，他2010年成为慈济的助学生，2012年毕业于 PLM， 获得中学教育学士学位，随后在菲律宾理工大学攻读菲律宾文学硕士学位，并成为一名高中和大学教师。身为慈济志工的贾米尔说，慈济基金会不仅在经济上支持助学生，他还为他们树立了正确的价值观。另一位助学生克斯汀·卡布洛认为，慈济不仅在经济上支持他的学业，慈济的人文课程更让他成为一个更好的自己。他目前正在 PLM 攻读英语中学教育学士学位。他说，人文课程教会了他们对他人要富有爱心的重要性，对需要帮助的人要伸出援手。他希望自己将来也能成为一位慈济志工。PLM 校长雷耶斯律师表示，就像一个精神父亲一样，看到孩子们成为他们自己，他不禁感到自豪。他说，非常荣幸能与一个与他们有着共同愿景的组织合作，即通过教育赋予个人权利。慈济创始人的愿景与他们的使命无缝契合，即不仅提供优质教育，而且提供全面的教育，不仅改变一个人，而且改变一个完整的人。非中新闻台综合报道。
有利东方旅游有限公司 Unary and Travel Incorporated。
So that was it. Did you guys have fun? Well, I sure did. I had such a great time here at Yao's Kitchen, you know, learning how to cook the beef salpicao together with Miss Jennifer Yao, as well as really, you know, trying out all those delectable, amazing Chinese dishes served a while ago. You know, I especially love that five lucky dish. So grab it talaga, no? Like once you buy it from them, they have all the five lucky dim sum as well as the other delectable dishes they serve here at Yao's Kitchen. Now, as you can see, right here, I also have these fish tikois that they sell at Yao's Kitchen. I really love it kasi sobrang cute ng fish. Yun. Dahil nga, in Chinese New Year, every time we have our dinner, kailangan may yu because nian nian yu yu. So every year, kailangan may auspiciousness and prosperity. Once again, my name is Candice Tan. Join us again next week for another episode of Chinatown TV. 非中电视台，我们下个星期再见。祝大家新年快乐，万事如意，恭喜发财。